I'm Edna Keith's mother. I was visiting my parents in Ritter, Oregon, and so I said, oh, where's your brother? And he said, oh, he went around the barn. Then we went back to find him, and he wasn't there.
According to Oregon State Police, there are 41 missing children in Oregon.
It's an unknown what happened to these people. It extends far beyond just kids.
Hundreds of people vanished from our national parks and forests under very unusual but very similar circumstances.
In a lot of these cases, search and rescue or the volunteer searching people have already gone over certain areas, not once, not twice, but even dozens of times. And then the child is found there, maybe a year, maybe a few years later.
I think that I'm actually sitting here holding my son. But this is what I have left of him.
We're talking about a very large, even worldwide, collective of information here.
We turned around, and here was this little toddler walking out of the fog with absolutely no clothes on at all.
Well, it's troubling. You know, I got members of my search and rescue movement that aren't sleeping too well.
If you have areas that you don't even know there's missing people, it makes it really difficult to reinvestigate when more information comes.
Some of these situations are so unusual, you have to think beyond the bounds of what's normal.
One of the reports says, well, the reason why you didn't find any DNA or blood or anything on Jared's clothing is because either he or something removed his clothing. There's just too much. There are too many questions that don't have answers.
When did the FBI get involved?
Family's been accused of drug use and of sleeping with certain people.
Everybody thinks, well, I'll come up to a polygraph. Go ahead. Go right on ahead. I have nothing to hide.
You know, everybody wants an answer. Hopefully someday we'll come up with one.
Does the National Park Service keep a list of missing people in their parks?